Some of the other students. It's a little weird, but not the worst thing ever. I've always done art as a hobby rather than something I struggle a bit with line consistency in general. I like a loose hand and lucky child. I just let my hand do all the work, regardless of accuracy. So at the very least, I decided to make some accurate coloring line-wise and my shades do the rest for me. Decided to go with brown hair for soft because I thought black would look a bit too blocky for the look. I know soft hair is closer to black than it is the color that I'm using, but using black can kind of ruin your picture when you decide to paint. So reason that I opted for the brown. At this point, I'm kind of struggling to make my wand tool work. Trying to make a selection and feather it, but Krita doesn't work for me very well. And you can see there's still kind of a highlight around Halo Effect. I thought this image color blocking without the line was actually really cool. What do you think? Just get rid of it, right? This is the layer that I start my shadows. I took the color that I used for her skin, added more red, made it a darker color on top of multiply. I know she is a little more olive toned, but I decided I've already made her quite bright, and the reference picture I used a lot of makeup on, so you know I gotta give her that contour. You can see me struggling a bit on how much detail I want on her face. The problem with stylized images is that you have to kind of give up certain details of realism for the sake of your style. I didn't want to make super harsh lines on her face, even though she has them a lot stronger than I. Style and something that looks familiar to a real person. So I opted for just going for a general feel rather than accuracy. I only used two brushes. Painting. I used the pressure pen, which changes sizes based on how hard I'm pressing on my screen, and the airbrush, which controls opacity and edges. I know there's plenty of people who use literally 12 brushes, but I wanted to do something simple and fast. This image took about an hour and a half to finish, I think. At this point, I went for a second shadow. Just get really get the darks since Soph is has a lot of dark features as far as her face and her hair and her style goes. I wanted to make them look the part. What do you think? Should I make more YouTube speed paintings? I might just do it for practice. Get used to my tools. I might just go and make a series out of this now that I have more time. Because the virus and all. I think it's cool that all the ASMR artists and YouTubers in general are making more content. They have more time. It's kind of nice to have more content when you're at home. A lot more. I kind of struggled a bit. Colors a little bit because my drawing screen is not as vibrant as my monitor. So, despite me picking certain colors, you, as the viewer, may see it as a different color. Whether it has more brightness, less value, and sometimes a different color altogether. And that's kind of the struggle with digital. When you look at it on your phone versus your TV, it may look completely different when it comes to color. And unless you are web designing, there's no point in using digital colors. You'd be wasting your time. Finally decided to go with a color that's closest to black. To just outline what's really the darkest colors. And it's kind of hard to show that she's wearing makeup without making it look ridiculous. I know Soph doesn't wear makeup often, but the reference I was using did have her with makeup on. If you couldn't tell by her Franken lipstick, when an anime form, you simplify it. I was trying to get of both worlds, but I guess them's the struggle. Simple forms like this speed painting just kind of helps with my studies and video, which is always nice. I was trying my best not to let my hand do whatever it wants, so I limited my highlights a bit and just used it as hair strands. I wish I spent more time on the background. I didn't think about making it too intense or busy, but I wanted to give Saf some homage with her bad bitch brand and her love for bats. So I just kind of stuck in the background and drew a little bat thing for her. I struggled with making it look cute, to be completely honest. Haven't gone to sleep yet. Thanks for hanging out. And if you have given up on sleep, feel free to go to my drawing channel. In quotations, it's me and my buddy Justin doing drawing challenges and games. You can find us at Skid Sketch.